Yes, students, we were on paragraph number 10. So I'm starting from the last paragraph of 9th also. A dash back to the car. Bruno still floundering about on his stumps, but clearly weakening rapidly. So a dash over here means ran back. So it ran back towards the car. Bruno was still, you know, it was still struggling to be on his own toes, but clearly weakening rapidly. So it was becoming weak, some vomiting, heavy breathing with heaving flanks and gaping mouth. So some vomiting, heavy breathing with heaving flanks and gaping mouth. So its condition was not very, stable. Vomiting, heavy breathing or panting, and side by side, it had its mouth open. So of course, when you are not able to breathe nicely or in a stable manner, you open your mouth. Hold him, everybody. In goes the hypodermic Bruno squeals. 10 cc of the antidote enters his system without a drop being wasted. So he's given the injection. 10 minutes later, condition unchanged. Another 10 cc injected. 10 minutes later, breathing less stertorous. Bruno can move his arms and legs a little, although he cannot stand yet. 30 minutes later, Bruno gets up and has a great feed. He looks at us disdainfully, as much as to say. So after 30 minutes, you know, this Bruno is a little conscious and he looks at the narrator and the others hatefully. What's a barium carbonate? What's a barium carbonate to a big black bear like me? Bruno is still eating. So Bruno, you know, is looking at the narrator and all. Disdainfully means distastefully, or you can say hatefully. And it appeared as if he just wanted to say like barium carbonate, something like that is nothing for a bear like me. Got it? So the point is like, was it easy to save the Bruno? No, it was not very easy. How many doses was he given? Two doses he was given. And afterwards he got a little better after 30 minutes. But the moment he was better, the moment he regained consciousness, he started eating again. So now it was as if that poison was nothing for him. Got it? But the reality is that it was too much for him. But the moment you are all right, you feel as if it was nothing for you. Right? You are to face the wall. That is a final instruction. Is that clear? And if you want to move about, tell me. Another time he found nearly 1 gallon of old engine oil, which I look at the book better, paragraph number 11, all of you. Another time he found nearly 1 gallon of old engine oil, which I had drained from the sump of the Studebaker and was keeping as a weapon against the inroads of termites. He promptly drank the lot, but it had no ill effects whatever. So first time, what was something which he had earlier? Barium carbonate, which was meant for the rats or mice. And he was saved somehow. Second time, he consumed a gallon of old engine oil. And this time, it did not have any effect on him. So why didn't it have any effect on him? Yeah. Yes. Yes, yes. Antibodies were already inside him. Or you can say like he had got some resistance to these kinds of things after having consumed barium carbonate. After having been treated for this, he might have developed resistance against these kinds of stupid things. Okay. The months rolled on. What does it mean? Months passed. Okay. Time elapsed. And Bruno had grown many times the size he was when he came. So what does it mean? Bruno had grown many times. Yeah, he grew up. size, physically, he grew up many times than the time when he had come. So when he came, he might have been about 2 kg, but by this time he had become about 10 or 15 kg. I'm just giving an example. He had equaled the Alsatians in height. He had equaled the Alsatians in height and had even outgrown them. So he, on the basis of this line, I'll ask you one question. He had equaled the Alsatians in height and had even outgrown them. The question is, Bruno was taller than Alsatians, right or wrong? Okay, Bruno was
right.
Right or wrong? Wrong. Equal. He had equaled the height of Alsatians. His height was all. Listen to me. It's written he had equaled the Alsatians in height. Height-wise, he was equal. But outgrown means like health-wise, he might have become healthier, heavier than the Alsatians. What's the meaning of height? Length, height. Okay, look there. He had equaled the Alsatians in height and had even outgrown them. Okay, so you mean like, but here outgrown may be taken for health-wise. Sometimes your height is same, okay? But some child, same height, but one can be healthier than the other one. Okay, but if you want to say, okay, his height was almost equal to Alsatian, but he had even become taller than some of the Alsatians. It's okay. Okay. He had equaled the Alsatians in height and had even outgrown them, okay? But was just as sweet, just as mischievous, just as playful. So maybe physically he had become as, healthy and tall like the Alsatians. But even then, this Bruno had not become wild. It was still as sweet and playful. And playful means lively, cheerful. And one more adjective is sweet and mischievous as well as lively. He was still a very mischievous and lively Bruno. What was it? Sloth bear. Yeah, it was still not wild bear. It was still a lively, playful and sweet one. Otherwise, wild animals are not sweet. Wild animals are not, lively. Wild animals cannot be tamed. Wild animals cannot be disciplined. Got it? If you want a wild animal to become disciplined, you cannot make him. So there can be wild students also. Those who cannot be disciplined. You keep on doing anything with them. There are many students in the class, those who have become absolutely fine. Come here and see the faces. I could never imagine them becoming so great. And sometimes when a child is becoming so good, we should mention the names also. For example, Jaskaran, Hirde, this boy, even that boy. No? And there are, and even this boy. But there are some those who are not changing. I won't name today. Okay. The months rolled on. Look at the text. Paragraph number 12. I'm halfway. Okay. Thank you so much. And he was very fond of us all. What does it mean, Bita? And he was very fond of us all. He loved us all. Yeah. He was very fond of us. Means he loved us all. Above all, he loved my wife and she loved him too. She had changed his name from Bruno to Baba, a Hindustani word signifying small boy. And he could do a few tricks too. Those who cannot look at the book will talk to me outside today. Look at the book. All of you look at the book. Look at the book. Straight. Who are? Alsatian dogs are there.
Breed of a dog.
It's a breed of the dog. Quite a big one, huge ones. Am I right?
Yes,
ma'am. A bit terrifying also. Okay. And he was very fond of us all. Above all, he loved my wife and she loved him too. She had changed his name from Bruno to Baba, something, the name which signifies a small boy. And he could do a few tricks too. At the command Baba wrestle or Baba box, he vigorously tackled anyone who came forward for a rough and tumble. Give him a stick and say, Baba, hold gun. And he pointed the stick at you. Ask him, Baba, where's the baby? And he immediately produced and cradled affectionately a stump of wood, which he had carefully concealed in his straw bed. But because of the tenants' children, poor Bruno or Baba had to be kept chained most of the time. So see, this even wild animal could had been trained well. He could show so many tricks. So if he would be asked to bring the baby, then he would cradle the, what would he cradle? Something which would look like baby? Stump of woods. So what else he would do? He could wrestle, he could tumble or the so many. So he would even show off as if he was holding a gun. But otherwise, was that really a gun?
Stick.
What was that? Stick. So point is, see his vocabulary. See his understanding. Okay, tomorrow oral test up till page number 13 and tomorrow written test also is there. Up till paragraph number 12 written test. And even of the previous chapter.